YouTube today at powerjackrepair.org, we got a Lenovo Legion Y540-15IRH, same as Y530, same as Y545, Y745, Y77i. It's all the same, pretty much all the same laptop. Now, we sell the parts from the link below for the replacement of this part. On your case, you know, here it shows that the two pins are sticking like that, meaning the black plastic rectangle right there is broken off. But in many cases that we see, people just wiggle it too much left and right, excessively. So in theory, you should see a black piece in there, but usually the people wiggle it back and forth and that's a bad connection. In this case, it's already broken. So yeah, this is becoming a relatively common model here. So let me show you how to take it apart. And you can fix it yourself at home, or you could send us the whole laptop, you could send us just the motherboard. If you want, you could buy the part from us. We accept donations. We prefer if you leave a like if the video was useful. So let's begin. We got four screws right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws right there. Let's unscrew this whole thing. Only problem is my drill bit is incorrect. All right, so let's begin unscrewing. All right, so four screws here. Another screw right there. This is a long screw right there. Alrighty, we got four long screws right there. Short screw right here. And should be one more screw there, but it's missing connection someplace. Alright, so the next thing, I believe that we need to move this guy forward. Yeah, no? I was thinking this whole thing moves. So on some of those models, this panel comes off. You have to kind of slide it this way. But on this model, this panel does not come off, because it's either bigger or smaller, and I'm not 100% sure which way it is. All right, so the thing to keep in mind, sometimes it cracks right there, sometimes it cracks right here when you try to open it up. So those are usually the places where you have to start trying to open it. Let's see if I will be able to open it from this end. Doesn't want to bulge. Let me find the guitar pick. Alrighty, so here I got the guitar pick, which I kind of put in there and glide everything like that. And the thing is, you have to kind of pinch this side like that. Let's see if we can get this guy out like that. Good job. And the jack is right there. So before we're going to touch anything else on the motherboard, what we want to do is we want to, first of all, change the field of view so you could see everything much better. We're going to disconnect this battery. All right, so we got five screws right here. All right, so here we're gonna disconnect the battery. And that's how you remove the battery. If you wanna replace the battery, that's how you replace the battery. So if you're watching this video on battery replacement, this is it. Strange. This cable, this cable. So this cable runs here, from here it runs right there. strange and interesting. So here we're gonna take this cable out like that. We're gonna remove this guy right here. We have to take this guy off because there is a screw under it. So we remove this wireless card altogether. Alright. And then there is this wire right here. It's more convenient for me to disconnect the wire like that. Alrighty. Like that, and like that. Good job. Alright, so here we got the NVMe solid state drive. You don't want to break it, so be extremely gentle on those pins. Alrighty. Here we got the keyboard cable. Remove the tape, remove the battery right here. Like that, good job. And here we got the hard drive. So it's a proper hinge, you just wanna unhinge the hinge. By the way, it's probably helpful if you're watching this on a big screen TV. All right. And here we got four screws, 1, 2, 3, 4 right there. Oh wow, take a look, there is an extra screw here found. It shouldn't be here. It was probably shorting the motherboard someplace. Alrighty. Alright. So that's probably the reason why it might not work, because it came from this end right here. Oh, look, another screw fell off right here, you see? So another screw fell off from this end. All because it wasn't screwed in properly to begin with. Wow. Yeah, I hope the screws weren't flying around and shorting the motherboard. And you can see how dusty this guy is and how dusty this area right there. So the next thing you wanna do is you wanna disconnect this guy right here. Some sort of ribbon cable that connects the two pieces together. Here we got the motherboard screw. Here we got two more screws right there. Alright, so those two screws have the bracket right here. We set the bracket aside. And we got one more screw right there. Somebody was screwing around with this before because the seal is broken. Alright. Good job. And now we do need to disconnect the heatsink as well as the fans, because there is a cable right there underneath the heatsink, the cable for the LED LCD screen. So you can't really take the motherboard out without disconnecting that cable. And this cable also needs to be unglued from the bottom. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna make sure that all of that garbage right here is soaked in. Alright. Because you see how dust accumulates at the top of the fans, meaning that nothing gets moved through, no air moving through. So that's the reason why those systems gonna die within no time whatsoever. So here we're just gonna take this whole thing, and we're gonna... Usually the dust settles at the heatsink, but here the dust settles at the fans, because the fans are designed improperly, I would say. I never seen a design like that. I guess it's made to pick up more air, but instead it picks up all the dust in the world. Alright, so here we wanna just make sure that this whole thing is nice and clean. Let's clean up. Alright, so we have to clean it up this way. Okay. Okay, like that, and like that. Good job. So next thing is right here, we disconnect the fan. Here we disconnect the fan as well. And here we got two screws for the fan. One and two. And we set the screws aside. Here we got one screw here. And one screw should be right there, but it's unreachable because of the heatsink. So there's one screw for the motherboard right here. And now we're gonna unscrew the heatsink. Alrighty, and here where you need to be extremely careful because it got some thermal pads on the bottom. Right here, you see the thermal pads right here. Those thermal pads, you want to make sure that they're still remaining there in the right place, okay? So let's clean up the garbage that we got here. Alright. Because all this garbage is going to be all over my work desk if I don't clean it up. Alright. Okay. Good job. Here. Disconnect that. Remove that. Disconnect this screw right there. There is some dirt in there or something. Yeah. Yeah, that's just dirt. And the dirt went all over my glove. Anyways. Like that. Alrighty. And now what I want to do, I want to clean up the GPU and the CPU. Because we're going to be putting a brand new thermal paste on this once we are done with the jack. Somebody was installing the thermal paste and go figure what kind of way. Alright, come on. It's pretty safe to clean the CPU here. There is no extra capacitors on the CPU. Like sometimes there are, and you have a possibility of damaging the board. All right, let's do a little bit more cleaning right here. All right. I don't like to clean the CPU with the alcohol because I'm afraid that something gonna get flown under the CPU. And all right, here we just wanna clean the top because it seems like the sides are not really that well cleanable. All right, and I also need to clean the thermal, the sink. I'm not gonna waste your time showing you how to clean that. I'm just gonna clean it, clean all of that stuff here. All right, so I cleaned up both of the CPU and GPU. Make sure every single pad remains in the right place. Make sure all of the excess garbage is cleaned as well. All right, so next thing is we wanna lift up this cable right here and kind of slowly guide it out like that. and you wanna unhinge the hinge right here and slowly guide this guy. Maybe lift it up slightly, maybe lift it up like that and like that. All right, and now I think this whole thing should be removable. There is usually a cable there someplace when you flip it this way like that. All right, you see this black cable right here? All right, now you disconnect it. All right, you want to set aside the async. You want to unplug the cable right here. All right, and we got the motherboard right there. All right, so what I'm going to do next, I'm going to use the thermal tape to insulate the area around the jack. Alrighty, so the way it works is I'm gonna add some flux right here on the top pins, on the pins around the jack. As you can see, I insulated the area with the Kapton tape. The Kapton tape will make sure that nearby components not gonna be damaged from excessive heat, and I will have much less work to worry about if something goes wrong. So Kapton tape is kind of an insurance for me that nothing gonna go wrong. And now we're just gonna add some solder to those connections right there in the back. Right here. Right there, right there, right there. Pretty much everywhere we're just adding the extra solder. And right here. All right. And now we're gonna flip the motherboard over and we're gonna add some solder there. We're gonna add some solder right there, right there, right there, and right here. Alrighty. Alright. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna heat up the jack just a little bit. The jack does not require much heat at all. And we're just gonna drop the jack from the motherboard. Alrighty. Like that, like that, like that. And like that. All right, so what I'm doing is by adding extra leaded base solder, it mixes with the unleaded base solder that's in there in the motherboard, and it drops the melting temperature downwards, making the jack easier to desolder, basically. Once the leaded base solder mixes with the unleaded base solder, it's gonna drop the temperature. Okay, so right now it was on the preheating mode, basically just like slightly heating up the components and penetrating the leaded solder into with the unleaded base solder. All right, and what I'm gonna do next is we're gonna power this guy up a little bit more and make sure that it's all gonna be coming out in a second out of here. All right. Again, what I'm doing is I'm mixing the leaded base solder with unleaded base solder. It could be done faster, it's not my laptop, so I am taking my time. All right, you see this? It started to move someplace, right? All right. Let's see, will it move here on the front as well? See, it should be moving in a second. This one will take a bit more because you see this whole thermal area is a bit too big to heat up right here. So we're gonna flip this guy over and we're gonna work our way from the back like that, and like that. Okay. We are getting there. Now we need to move this guy right there. Okay. And now we just need to, yep, like that. So now we reduce the heat to simmer. We no longer force the air that much. And now we're gonna bring in the soldering wick and use the soldering wick to desolder all of the remaining solder. Alrighty. And okay. Alrighty, so here we got on the top end, we got this guy right here. I'm cleaning up the holes from both sides. Alright, the traces, make sure that the holes are empty. Once they're empty, we are able to put in a brand new jack. And they seem to be just fine right now. Let's see. Yeah, I need to clean up that pad a little bit more right here. Right there. Alrighty. Looks good to me. Let's find a brand new replacement jack for this. Alright, so the next thing that I want to do is probably remove the thermal paste. I meant to say remove the thermal tape, not paste. The tape. Alright, so while removing the thermal tape, I saw that no components fly off the motherboard, it seemed to me. Uh-oh. I'm not sure if there was a component right here or not. Let's double check the tape. Tape doesn't have any components on it. You see, that's the reason I use the tape. I'm not sure if this is the, if there was any component right there or not. Probably not, because it would be right here, right? Anyways, we're gonna add some flux right here, right here, and pretty much all over the place there. We're gonna drop the new jack in place like that. Raise up. You see the difference? That's the broken jack and that's not broken jack. In the way that the jack looks like in the front there. Okay. So here. Excellent. Good job. Right, let's flip it over. Let's see if we can do exactly the same good job here on the bottom. We always want to add a whole bunch of flags. All right. Once we add the flags, all right, just want to finish up this guy right here. It's a ground, that's a plus. Just make sure that everything is solders through just fine. Let's see on the other side. Everything looks beautiful. I don't need to touch up anything here. All right, so the only thing left to do is to clean the whole thing up and put it all back together. Alrighty, so we're cleaning this thing up like that. Alright. Clean up this thing like that, like that. Now let's wipe out the excess. Alrighty. Alright, let's switch the side to the other side. Alrighty. Good job. Wonderful. Alrighty, so let me show you the final product. You see how well the solder got on the top. Now we got this side like that. Everything's penetrated just fine. Let me just double check to make sure that the current is gonna be conducting just fine. Here, let's see. Ground is fine, plus is fine. Plus is fine, ground is fine, data signal is fine. All right, good job. Alrighty, so the thing we need to start with is the cable, the little tiny cable that I disconnected from the motherboard should go right here. So let's flip the hinge over and let's put the tiny cable into the motherboard like that. Good job. Now the next cable we got right here, we want to flip the hinge over and guide the cable in. You know, come on, here the hinge is closing down on me. Like that. Flip this guy over like that. And like that. Now this cable you have to be extremely careful about, simply because you're not gonna find a cable like that anywhere in the United States for sale if you mess it up. So you have to be ridiculously careful about this cable. Don't even breathe in it. Right, make sure the hinge is all the way out. Come on. I have to take my gloves off to make sure I can just guide it using my fingers. And I want to guide it in a way so that the pins won't get broken. Some little dust went in there. Alright, so now we're gonna close it down like that. Good job. Alright, now is a good time to connect the battery. Let me put the anti-static gloves on. They also collect a lot of dust. So here we wanna connect the battery. We wanna remove this guy right here and connect the keyboard like that. Like that. Like that. Here we go, like that, right here. And we got a screw going down right here. And a screw going down, I think, right there. All right. And we got a cable right here that we want to connect right there. Close it down and leave it like that. Now one other screw, I believe, is right here someplace. Okay, I believe it's a longer one going in right here. Okay, that bracket right here going on like that. And we got screw right here. All right. And we got another screw going in right there. Okay. Alrighty. Now don't forget we have the fans like that, and we got long cables for the fans, long screws for the fans. Alrighty. And another one going in right here. Okay. We also have this fan right here. And let's see if it's gonna go in just fine. One right there. One right here. And one. And that's it. One, two. Okay. Alrighty. What else am I missing? I'm missing the hard drive, which we're gonna mount right now, right here. First, I want to connect the hard drive. Close it down. And then I want to looks good to me. I want to reconnect this connector because I'm not 100% sure if that connector is... Alright, so here I think the silver screws go in here, right? My understanding. One. Two. And make sure that the cable won't get damaged. Three and four. Good job. Okay. Next thing is we connect this wireless card right there. close it down like that. Like that, like that. And guide the wires through right there. Put some tape on top of those wires, because sometimes in shipping they have tendencies to fall off. And the client always demands the money back, because the internet doesn't work, right? Nobody can use the USB wireless cards anymore. So like that. Alright, so the remaining thing left to do is to put the heatsink on and the battery. And we got the hard drive right here. The hard drive. And let's make sure. Alright. SSD drive is in there. And now we just have to add some thermal paste. Alrighty, so we're adding some thermal paste. Not too much, just enough. I don't want the thermal paste to be all over the place here. Just a tiny bit. But enough to cover the top area. Alright. Looks good to me. Wonderful. Okay. Alrighty, so let me change the view. Alright, so the pads, make sure all of the pads are in the right place. Make sure when you flip them over, they're still gonna be in the right place. And what you wanna do is you wanna attach everything top-down approach. Don't smooch around anything around here, because the pads, you probably wanna grab it like that. Because those pads might not go right where you need it to go. So I'm just gonna pre-torque the screws. Alrighty. And don't over-torque the screws, just make sure they're, you know, once they stop screwing, you stop screwing, alright? So just like, easy on the screws. Alrighty, wonderful, good job. Okay, so one last thing left to do is to connect the battery. It's easier to connect the battery before you're gonna screw down the battery. Alright, and then you're just gonna drop the battery like that. Make sure the battery connector is all the way in. Now you just screw it down. Alright. Alrighty. Alright. And a few more screws, one right here. And one right there. Good job. So let's put the bottom cover on. Again, if the video was useful, please consider to leave a like. And subscribe. I will let you know which laptops, make and models I would spend my money on, and which I would never even bother even using, even if they're free. So for right now, we're just gonna connect it like that. We got four screws here on the bottom. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. And six should be right here. Should be something there, but I don't have a screw like that. I mean, I don't want to experiment with the screw, because if the screw is too long or too fat, it's gonna mess up the and mess up the whole thing. Already like that. Like that. Now this one requires 11.5 amps. Unfortunately, I don't have anything that powerful, so I will try to power it up with slightly lower amperage power supplies, and we will see how it's gonna work, if it's gonna work all right. So client information, hopefully you didn't see it. Okay, let's see. I found this dongle right here. Some of those dongles don't ever work. No, this one shows something. All right, so let's see if this dongle, I'm gonna power up this Toshiba power supply. I'm gonna power up this laptop. Maybe, possibly, I don't know. All right, nice and tight. We got the response right away. Orange light right there. Something going on here. So technically, the jack should be fine. I'm not sure if it's gonna power up and work, because there were loose screws on the inside. You've seen how loose some of the screws were. I will let it charge a little bit, because this power supply is not enough amperage for this laptop to work. i5-9 generation, wow. Let's see if you're gonna be able to jump start it. Well, the orange light is still on right there, but nothing so far. I mean, we do get lights, and it says here, connected AC adapter has a lower wattage than the recommended AC adapter, which was shipped. To use AC adapter, please connect the AC adapter, which was shipped with the system. Press escape. Okay, press escape, and we got the Legion on the screen. Yeah, because this adapter is 9.5 amps, and this laptop needs 11 amps. Now, the thing should charge in theory, but because it's not 11 amps, I don't know if it's gonna charge or not. That's a good question, right? I don't have 11 amps here, so I don't know if this laptop gonna work or not. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let it be plugged in like that, see if it's gonna charge up. If it's gonna charge up, great. All right. Anyways, please leave a like, subscribe, and you guys have a good day. All right. Thank you. Bye.